On this 31st of May 2020. Today is a Sunday, but still the MUHS is taking pain to arrange such type of the webinars or the e-learning programs for the eager students. I will add that because it is a Sunday and every person say, no, it's a Sunday, it's a relaxing time. But I think the teachers who have the passion of teaching and the students who have the passion of learning, they will come on the public holidays as well as the Sundays. Anyway, today's topic is my types of kapha dosha and presented by myself, that is Professor Dr. Rajendra Raghuveer Deshpande. I am MD in Ayurvedic medicine, Kaya Chikitsa, as well as Ayurvedic physiology, that is the Sharira Kriya or the Kriya Sharira subject. My mobile address or WhatsApp number is 9226810630. My mail ID is professordeshpande@gmail.com. We will start our lecture as usual. My own wish to start by some chanting mantras, beginning prayer. So let me allow that. Please sit straight, roll your shoulders back, and try to concentrate on this prayer. Sarvepi sukhinah santu, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchit dukham apnuya. Om shanti, shanti, shanti. Thank you. I used to use this particular very nice, fantastic tradition of Indian culture or Vedic culture. When I traveled from 1994 to 2014, America, Switzerland, Germany, Italy, and Spain for Ayurvedic propagation, I delivered a lot of lectures and I started always with some prayer and also end my prayer. When I do the Panchakarma, I start with the prayer and end with also the prayer. This is a very good Indian Vedic culture, Indian Vedic tradition. So I request that everybody can take the advantage of this type of prayer meditation. Okay, this makes the concentration on the particular subject. To begin with, I would like to thanks again and again to the Vice Chancellor of Maharashtra University of Health Science. Then I would like to thanks the Chief Coordinator, Registrar Dr. Kalidas Chavan of MUHS, and also Mr. Ratnakar Kale, then all their faculty members to arrange this type of the webinars, technical support. Kedar is there. I am thankful to all these people. So for giving this opportunity to share my knowledge and experience through the prestigious platform, underline prestigious platform of MUHS e-learning. I also thanks to my backbone of my institute, that is Dr. Professor Bagini Patil Madam, dynamic lady, for giving me such boost, always encouraging to do such type of activities. That's why I am also the academic director in my particular college. Okay. So purpose of this presentation is types of kapha dosha is a syllabus from the first year BMS. So the people, the students who have already completed with their respective teachers, these always syllabus, and now they will appear for online internal examination this first week of June or second week of June, because the university is expected to submit the results, MUHS, that 30th of June 2020 is the last date of submission of the results. So be prepared. I wish you all the best. And this is the revision for you. But these videos will be there permanently. This is a permanent, these e-learning programs. So whenever the students will join in 2020 in 70 colleges of Maharashtra or 350 colleges of India, these Ayurvedic students will definitely approach to the MUHS e-learning and they will be benefited by this stored digital library. Okay. So purpose is the first is revision, then to teach you in a simplest manner and to build up the confidence amongst yourself. Then as I am a practitioner person, that means at the past, I am very actively practicing and now it's a little bit passively practicing, but I have practiced a lot at national and international level. So I always share my personal experiences regarding Ahar, Vihar, and Aushadhi. Food, lifestyle and medicines. These are the tripod of the Ayurvedic management. So what can be the question in coming internal examination or MUHS examination? Describe Kapha Dosha in detail, write down the Nirukti, then write down what else, the Sthana, Guna, Karma, and describe the types of Kapha Dosha. This is big question. But they can make the compartments and make a SAQ. Write about Kledaka Kapha, Bodhaka Kapha, Avalambaka Kapha, Shleshaka Kapha, and Tarpaka Kapha. So these are the five types of Kapha Dosha. Kledak, Bodhak, Avalambak, Shleshak, Tarpak. Say five times. Kledak, Bodhak, Avalambak, Shleshak, and Tarpak. But before going to further, I request all my students that time is less with us and I want to share much my knowledge. So if you have any doubts, if you have any suggestions, if you have your kind feedback, please do write to me on my email, professordeshpande@gmail.com. You're always welcome and I will answer you. So these are some of the reference books. Of course, here, all things are recorded. So my dear students, your prime duty to study all your syllables from the basic Samhita Granthas, Charaka, Sushruta and Vagbhata, Ashtanga Sangraha Rudraya, then Yogaratnakar, Bhavaprakash, whenever needed. And most important, you attend your own teacher's lectures. Take the benefit of their teaching, take the benefit of their notes, and then by chance, if you require, you can refer my these books, Priya Sharir Paper 1, Priya Sharir Paper 2 by Shantanu Publication, Vaidya Rajendra Deshpande. Here you can see my name and the Shivaji Vavar. This is for fast revision, Priya Sharir Handbook. This may be a little bit out of print right now. Then this is Priya Sharir Practical Book is also available. Clinical examination. This is not only for first year. From first to last year, this will be very useful. Then textbook of in English textbook. Okay. So this is also available on the Amazon.com. Then, my dear friend, this is the syllabus points mentioned in the CCIM syllabus. Vyutpatti, Nirukti of the term Kapha. General location, that is Sthana. Properties, Guna, and functions, Karma. And then five types of Kapha. Bodhak, Avalambak, Kledak, Tarpak, and Shleshak, sequence made here and there with the specific location, sthana, specific properties, and specific functions. Okay. As I am repeatedly telling you, my dear friends, dosha, dhatu, mala concept is the base of Ayurvedic treatment. I am MD in Ayurvedic medicine, try to understand, Kai Chikitsa, and also in the Sharirya. So I know the link. First, you know, you confident Sharira Kriya, then Nidana subject, and then you will be definitely successful in your Ayurvedic Kaya Chikitsa subject or starting your own Ayurvedic consultation or general practice, I'm sure. But don't miss this chance to learn very hard all the dosha concept, dhatu concept, and mala concept. What is the another name for Kriya Sharira? Dosha Dhatu Mala Vijnana. Dosha Dhatu Mala Vijnana. And that particular subject, Dosha Dhatu Mala Vijnana, has a base. Dosha Dhatu Mala Moolam Hi Chariram. So these are the basic body elements, human body elements, like Dosha, Dhatu and Mala. Doshas are like the bioenergies. Vata is a kinetic energy. Pitta is a thermal energy. And Kapha is a mechanical energy. My dear friends and my teachers, kindly excuse me. I am using English terminology, some modern physiological concepts only for better understanding of Ayurvedic concepts. I don't want to replace Ayurveda with modern. I want this modern knowledge as a supplement and complement to the Ayurveda. Supplement and complement to the Ayurveda. Write down these words. So modern knowledge should be like a pinch of salt. Pinch of salt. If it is added more or whole, food will be destroyed. Your taste will be lost. Okay. So whatever the Kapha Dosha concept, its vyutpatti, its guna properties, they are applicable. Why I'm giving you this slide? They are applicable to Kledak, Bodhak, Avalambak, Shleshak, Tarpak. Because Kapha is a bioenergy. It is doing two main functions. Please write down, my dear friends, two main functions. One is a nutrition. Poshana karta, poshan. Every body elements are nourished with the kapha molecules. Nutrition. And number two, stability. Number two, stability. And number three, third important function, prevention from the degenerative or catabolic effect of vata and pitta. I will repeat the main three functions of kapha dosha, which are applicable to the sub types of kapha dosha. They are doing all these functions. Number one, either they will nutrition to the different organs, nutrition. Number two, stability, maintenance. And number three, prevention or protection from the degenerative activity of pitta and vata dosha. Because pitta is ushna and tikshna, and vata dosha is a drying. And kapha is a snigdha, shita, guru, snigdha, anchas, lubrication. Snigdha, okay? Guru, nourishes. Yasya dravyasya, bruhane, karmani, shaktihi, sa guru. What is guru? Guru is a nourishing, not only overweight. Guru is a nourishing. Shita, controlling the degeneration. Shita, controlling the degeneration. Write down this word, controlling degeneration. So, kena jalena phalati iti kapha. Kapha is having prithvi and jala predominance. Prithvi and jala. And it is always get support from the udak dhatu, jalena phalati, which will activate it by the addition of the udak dhatu. Water is very essential element for kapha dosha. Okay? And then shlisha alingane. Shlisha, union of the two molecules, not breaking. Breaking is vata and pitta. Breaking, vata and pitta. Union, shlisha alingane, kapha dosha. Love, affection, attraction. Next. So this is union. I have shown over here. Water molecule, glucose molecule. This is all like a kapha activity. Shlisha alingane. Symbolic. This is saumya. Very gentle in its action. Gentle in its structure. Okay. Saumya, sthira, stable. Kapha is always giving stability. It is preventing the unnecessary degeneration. You know, our body needs both. What both the things? Anabolism and catabolism. So anabolism plus catabolism is equal to metabolism. So I am not saying catabolism is not needed. After 120 days, RBC should die. RBCs should die after one, that is lifespan. But it should not be died at the 15th day. Okay, 15 days, 60 days. So adequate time span for each molecule is maintained by kapha dosha. Ambha prithvi vyam teshma. Okay, kapha. This is kapha. Then snigdha, shita, guru, manda, shlakshna, mritsna, sthira, kapha. These properties are applicable to the types of kapha dosha. My dear friends, please note this point. These properties are applicable to Kledak, Bodak, Avalambak, Shleshak, Tarpak, Snigdha, Kledane, Snigdha, lubrication. Shita, Stambane, Shitaha, Guru, Yasya, Bruhan, Yasya, Bruhanasya, Karmani, Shakti, Sadguru. Okay? Manda, Mando, Yatra, Karna. Continuous process of nutrition, maintenance. These are the normal functions, Sandhi, Sansleshana. You know, Shleshak, Tarpak, Snehana, Ropana, Purana, Balasthaya Krut, Shleshma, Panchada, Paravibhaktaha, Udaka Karmanam, Anugraham Karoti. Give the power and strength to the molecules with the hydration. Kapha Udaka Karmana, hydration is necessary. Our human body is composed by 70% water. Do you understand? 70% water, although we are living solid. Here, those who have not attended my previous lectures of Pitta types, let me remind them. Doshas are important for the swastha person. How doshas are important? Kledak bodhak avalambak. Samadoshaha samagnishcha samadhatu malakriya. Prasanna atma indriya manaha swastha iti avidiyate. Samadosha. Not excess, not low. Homeostasis. Pleuric both, pleuric cough, not too low. Hyper and hypo should not be there. So this is maintenance, physiological maintenance. If pleuric cough, podic cough, vitiated, prakupita, pathological changes in the pleuric podic cough, what they will do? You know how the vyadhi is regenerated, how the vyadhi disease is created? Dosha, dusha, sammurchana, janito vyadhihi. Prakupita dosh he dhatu ani malanavarti attack karatat. Vitiated doshas, they attack on the weaker rasarakta mamsmeda or mutra purisha sveda. Weaker part is more important, that is called a dusha. And together, prakupita dosh and dusha sammurchita, that is a bad pathological amalgamation, makes the disease or the vyadhi. Okay? So these are the general sthana, important places. Again, vata pitta kapha are the power plant, PLANT. That's a vidyut, electricity plant, astatna, like the electricity plant. These are the kinetic energy plant, then thermal energy plant, mechanical energy plants, and some are the power stations. Write down this word, power stations. These are the important places. Pleuric, bodhak, avalambak, kleshak, tarpak. And another importance, the names. Names are very interesting. All the names suggest important function of that type. All the function, all the names, pleuric, it will suggest kledana, moistening. Bodhak, bodhana, understanding of test. Kleshak, kisha alingane. So all these names will suggest the important function of that type. Okay? We will start directly with the five types. Ashtanga Sangra Sutra Sthan, Avalambak, Pleuric, Bodhak, Tarpak, Shleshakatva, Bhedaihi, Shleshma. In the last lecture at 12:30, my dear friends, those who have not attended, go to the YouTube and see that I have already completed my cardiac cycle lecture on the MUHS. I have already completed Avasthapak and Vipak lecture on the MUHS. Please go on the site of MUHS and take the advantage of these lectures. My dear friends, how the evolution or progress is taken in the Ayurvedic science? Very important example. Charaka Samhita has mentioned only types of Vata Dosh, Pran, Udan, Vyan, Saman, Apan. Charak has not mentioned the types of Pitta and Kapha. He has mentioned Pitta Kapha, but not subtypes. Sushruta, he has mentioned the types of Vata Dosh, types of Pitta Dosh, but not types of Kapha Dosh. And Vagbhata, he has mentioned five types of Vata, five types of Pitta, five types of Kapha. Sushruta, while explaining the Pachaka Pitta types, he used the word not Pitta, Agni. Pachaka Agni, Ranjaka Agni, Sadaka Agni. Do you understand? Okay. Kledaka Kapha, first type. Yastu Amashya Samsthitaha, Kledakaha. So, Anna Sanghata Kledanath. Which is mostly in the stomach part, Amashya, upper part of the abdominal viscera. And what is doing? It is giving the moisture for helping, indirectly helping to the digestion process. Primary digestion, sthula pachana. Main factor is pachak pitta. Without it, you cannot cook. Again, take the same example of rice cooking, vegetable cooking. We put the rice grain, water. Water is important before starting your gas. You forget to put the water, first thing your wife will scold you or mother will scold you, and if the gents are doing, and otherwise what will happen? Whole rice will be burned and you will be lost your food. Similarly, in the vegetables, we put little bit oil, little bit ghee for before the frying, either or. What is this? These particular substances are like kledaka kapha, moistening that particles to make the action of fire more good, more intensely. So pachak pitta will act good if the food is softened. Otherwise, cooking will not be proper. Madhurya kledana means moistening, lubrication. okay, giving the watering to park for the digestion. So this is indirectly helping to the primary sthula pachana, and that is very important. As you know, two types of pachana: sthula pachana from mouth to the small intestine, villi, and then what is that? Dhatugata or dhatu, not dhatugata, dhatu level pachana, tissue metabolism, sukshma pachana at the srotas. So that particular tissue metabolism will be good if your basic metabolism is good. So kleda kapha pachak pitta saman vayu are controlling all other kapha pitta vata molecules. Madhurya pichilatva prakleditva tathivacha amashaya sambhavati kleshma madhura shitala. You remember the avasthapa, madhura avasthapa. Annasya bhukta matrasya shatrasasya prapatata madhuratat kafodbhavat phena bhut udiryate. This line also you can add over here. This is the function of kleidak kapha. Secretion, giving the moisture, lubrication, watery, making the particles loose for the proper action of pachak pitta. So all the mucoid secretions, bodhak kapha is also a part of that pratham avasthapa. So tatrastha eva svashaktya sheshanam shleshma sthananam sharirasya cha udaka karmanam anugraham karoti. You should understand this sentence. This kleda kapha is controlling physiology of all other kapha molecules. You will understand, don't understand, sir, there is a connection of the vessels, nerves, and they taking the kleda kapha there? No, no, my dear friends. Kleda kapha is maintaining your sthula pachana, primary digestion. Okay, ahar rasa, pratham avasthapak, dvitiya avasthapak, tritiya avasthapak, vipak. If this ahar rasa is excellent, then naturally it will be circulated nutrients part to the each and every cell, and that's why they are helping the other kapha molecules in the body. That is that particular explanation. How the kleda, it don't have any direct relation, try to understand. Next, so this is I already explained how we are using this vidravana or olava. मराठी मध्ये इथे लिहिलेलं आहे भाजी डाळ वरण शिजवताना आपण तेल तूप पाकतो आणि पाचक पित्ताचं पचन कार्य अणुरेणूंपर्यंत तो अग्नि पोहोचतो. सम वर्ड्स आर इन मराठी. प्लीज सम स्टुडंट्स अँड टीचर्स मीज अलाउ मी टू यूज बोथ द लँग्वेजेस, मराठी एज वेल एज द इंग्लिश. सो दीज आर द गोब्लेट सेल्स, म्युकस सिक्रेटिंग ग्लँड, गोब्लेट सेल्स. सो दीज सम पिक्टोरियल गिव्ह द मोर इम्प्रेशन. म्युकॉइड ग्लँड, म्युकोसा, म्युकोसल लाइनिंग इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. ओके, अदरवाइज if there is no mucus glands, what will happen? That hydrochloric acid, pachak pitta, or enzymes, pancreatic enzymes, that will destroy that organ. That's why I have mentioned what is the purpose of that kapha, giving the protection from the degenerative effect of vata and pitta. Peristaltic movements are there, continuous movements are there, rukshata will be created, ushnata is there, pitta heat is there. To protect from that vata and pitta, kleda kapha is essential for protection of that organ and to help for the digestion purpose. Remember, now you want to avoid the pitta, kleda kapha vruddhi or kleda kapha kshay. How you can avoid pathology? To drink enough water at the time of food, lunch. Whenever you eat lunch or dinner or breakfast, what Ayurveda says, as per your own prakruti, as per your own thirst, sip by sip water should be taken during the food, during the lunch, full process. It should not be before, it should not be after. Rules of water taking should be followed for maintenance of kleda kapha. If unnecessary drinking of water, that can damage the physiology of kleda kapha. If you avoid the water, not only water, my dear friends, if you eat totally dry food substances, always only vada pav, only sandwiches, no rice, no wheat, chapati, rice, nothing, curry, buttermilk, milk, ghee, nothing is there, dry food is there, then definitely your whole digestion will be hampered. Ahar rasa will not be formed, there will be ama formation, and that will obstruct all the channels. So kleda kapha should be maintained by proper adequate food consumption with jaliya substances. They include fruit juices, water, medicated water, milk, and all these substances. The ghee little bit, so all these will help in the clay duct cover. But water excess and water low will damage clay duct cover. Okay. Next, rice cooking. See, don't forget this water content. This is clay duct cover. Mucous glands again, avalambak. Second type is avalambak. Urastaha, in the chest region, ura, chest. Trikasya, three organs are there. Swaviryataha, by its own potentiality, kapha is always, kapha molecules are nutritious. Rudayasya annaviryacha, giving proper blood supply. Annavirya, aharrasa, coming from the aharrasa, there are some kapha molecules. And eva ambukarmana. Ambu means water. Again, again, again. Kapha is always related with udaka dhatu. Apya, jala mahabhuta. So ambu is a jala mahabhuta. And what is the main function of jala mahabhuta? Giving the proper hydration, maintenance of interstitial fluid. Write down these words. Interstitial, body cells, fluid is there in between. So that all watery part, intracellular fluid, extracellular fluid, that is maintained by kapha molecules. Here also, in this chest region, they are maintaining the healthy condition of this chest organ. Kapha dhamnam cha sheshanam yat karoti avalambanam ato avalambakah sheshma. Bhagavad is saying that this avalambakah is important. Why? I will show you the following lines. Urastha trikasya sandharanam atmavirena, own molecules of kapha. Annarasa sahiten, aharasa is also important. Rudaya avalambanam karoti. Rudaya avalambana. Write down this word, avalambana. And here Arundhata Tikakar, critics, has given avalambanamiti swakarmani samarthyam utpadayati. This line is most important. Avalambaka, avalambanamiti swakarmani samarthyam utpadayati. Swakarmani, what is my function? Now, what is this trika? We will see. Basically, I will explain. Trika means three regions, and most of the Vaidyas, most of the Ayurvedic experts, they believe that Urastha trika means heart, lung, and mediastinum. Heart, lung, mediastinum, three region. Or some say right and left lobe of the, or lungs, right and left lung, and heart is also can be called as a trika. So there is a difference of opinion in different people. I personally feel mostly you consider the maintenance of heart and lungs. You write down, avalamba kapha is mainly maintaining physiology of normal functioning of heart and lung. Rudaya ani phuphusache swasthya. That is maintained by avalamba kapha. It may be interstitial fluid, pleural fluid, pericardial fluid, all the things which are nourishing to the heart and lung, which are giving stability to the heart and lung. Why? Why? Because heart and lungs are working. Heart and lung, right on, heart and lungs are working from birth to death, non-stop. So movement, lapped up, movement, vata dosh, remember, vata dosh. So whenever there are movements, what is necessary? Lubrication is necessary. Marathi madhe tala vangan mantat, vangan. When you drive your motorcycle, motorbike, when you drive your cars, when you drive your aeroplane, anything, when you drive, there is engine, and that engine with the heat and with the movement, with the vata and with the pitta, machine parts are getting degenerated. Machine parts are getting degenerated. Heart and lung is a machine. It is getting shiryate tacchariram. But we want to live for 100 years. How we can live? There should be some antagonistic controlling factor. Antagonistic, opposite controlling. If there is a movement, if there is heat, there should be some cooling. You know, in our car, C-A-R, car, there is a coolant, you know, coolant, C-W-L-E-N-T, very much essential. It is avalambakav. Coolant is avalambakav. Te aapnele vicharatat, mechanic always ask, sir, te oil badlaycha ka tumcha gaadi cha, oil change karaycha ka. Sometimes oil is so below, all of a sudden your vehicle cracks, no movement. सर ते सगळं तुमचं इंजिन खराब झालं, इंजिन डाऊन करावं लागेल, सगळं सर ऑइलच संपलं होतं, तुमचं लक्षच नव्हतं. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? इफ देर इज नो ऑइल इन युअर इंजिन, इन युअर मशीनरी ऑफ हार्ट अँड लंग, देन देर इज अ प्रॉब्लेम. अवलंबत्व इज देअर. नाउ माय डिअर फ्रेंड्स, द क्वेश्चन इज हाऊ यू कॅन मेंटेन द फिजिओलॉजी ऑफ अवलंबत्व, नॉट एक्सेस नॉट लो, सो दॅट प्लुरल फील्ड, पेरिकार्डियल फील्ड should be protected, it should be taken care of from any internal or foreign toxin. Aam, so your ahar rasa, because here it is ahar rasa, here ahar rasa, anna rasa sahi dena. So your prathamika sthula pachan should be best quality, your stools should be normal, your appetite should be normal, your sthula pachan should be normal, then nutritious ahar rasa will maintain that avalambhata. And secondly, your blood circulation should be purified, because hrudayasyaanne veeryaach tasthe evam karmana. And third thing, again, kapha molecules anywhere, they are maintained by proper body hydration, enough water drinking as per your prakruti, as per agni, as per season, adequate water. I am saying adequate, optimal, there is no definition, 1.5-2 liters, no, it depends on the person to person. But and secondly, local some activity. For example, if you take a deep breathing, pranayam. What is that pranayam? Pranayam is controlling your respiration, controlling your respiration. If you are doing 14 to 17 per minute ara respiratory rate, by pranayam you can reduce it to the 10. So naturally what happens? There is a less requirement of avalambha kapha, and avalambha kapha will be maintained in a low amount. So that is a preventive aspect. If I do the meditation, for example, what is happening? Parasympathetic activity is taking place. Parasympathetic reduces the heart rate 70 to 80 to 90 per minute. But that can be 60, 70, 72. If it is on the lower side, cardiac activity, lumped up activity is lower down, need of avalambha kapha will be less. Third, you have to apply externally small oil massage on the chest and back intermittently in as a part of abhyanga. That can also help as a avalambha kapha external nutrition. And then there is a rudabasti. Please write down rudabasti with punarnava oil, punarnava tel. So if you do on the heart region, punarnava, the name of the plant, punarnava, regeneration. So regeneration of avalambha kapha molecules, regeneration of avalambha kapha molecules by ruda basti, local basti, is not enema, it's local basti with the dove, and punarnava oil or narayan oil, shatavari oil, you have to put it over there. I hope you are understanding a little bit applicative part of that avalambha kapha. And here they have written kapha dhamnanja sheshanam, like kledar kapha. How these kapha molecules are helping to all other molecules? I think very simple. If you are maintaining the swakarmani, heart and lungs, if their functions are excellent, excellent, naturally your whole body gets the proper oxygen and proper blood circulation, which is nothing but the nourishment. Do you understand? All the cells of the body, they will get good amount of nourishment, and that will help to maintain the kapha molecules in the body. So this is this kapha dhamnanja sheshanam. All other places will be controlled by heart lung protection, nourishment. Okay. Next. So this is understanding of pleural fluid and pericardial fluid. You know the pleurisy, pleuritis is a disease which is a problem of avalambha kapha. Okay. Next, avalambha kapha, pleural, visceral pleura and parietal pleura. Okay. It is just a comparison. Please, my Ayurvedic teachers and friends, Dr. Deshpande is not replacing Ayurveda, not replacing Ayurveda. He is giving in English or physiological examples or the sentences only to supplement complement to the Ayurvedic knowledge. Okay, some Tikakar, Arundhat or Hemadri or some Dallan, they have mentioned the different parts as a trick. I personally my feeling is that is only for theoretical aspect. Somebody say here, for example, these two clavicles and that vertebral column, that part is also having considered as a trick. Then if you go on the bottom of the vertebral column, that sacrum and the pelvic girdle, two parts, that particular region can be also called as a trik. So tapha molecules on the upper part or the lower part of the vertebral column, it is also considered as a trik by some tikaka, like for example Dallan and Arundhata Hemadri. But personally, Dr. Deshpande believes that trika should be considered as heart, lung and mediastinum. That's it. Okay, next, bodhaka kapha. Bodhaka rasa bodhanat, bodhana to give the knowledge, understanding. Rasa bodhana, which knowledge? Rasa, test. Can you see here? Rasa bodhana, rasa is a test, you know, madhura, amla, lavana, katu, tikta and kashaya, sweet, sour, salty. Madhura, amla, lavana, katu, pungent, tikta, bitter, astringent, kashaya. All these six tests of the food are can only be perceived if there is enough moisture, hydration in the mouth region. You know, on my tongue there are taste buds. Taste buds has the connection with the brain. That is called as a gustatory pathway. Please write it down, gustatory pathway. But that current action potential will develop only when your taste buds are stimulated. Taste buds are stimulated, and taste bud will need the food in watery or solvent medium. That's why we have the saliva. Saliva secretion can be compared as a bodhaka kapha secretion, and that is mandatory to understand, to pursue the knowledge of taste. And that is very important, because your prathama avastha part will start from the tylene enzyme. So jivha mula kantastho jivendriyasya samyatva samyak rasajnana vartate. It is according to Sushrut, it is at the tip, origin, back side of the tongue, because there are the villi and also kantha region. Why he has also mentioned the kantha region? That gives you the sensation of thirst. When your mouth is totally, I am speaking since last 2 hours, so naturally there will be, maybe at the moment there are a lot of secretions, but excessive consumption of my voice can make my mouth dry, and that is very bad situation for my metabolic process. Try to understand, pachan is always normal when there are vata pitta kapha harmony is there, harmony, proper pranavayu is there, proper bodhak kapha is there, pachak pitta, samana vayu, apana vayu, kledak kapha. All these factors together with coordination can only make your sthula pachana normal. Ahar rasa will be of good quality. So it starts from the bodhak kapha. So bodhak kapha has very important role for maintenance of our whole body nourishment. You can understand, it is not only understanding of the thirst, but kapha is also doing the, what it does? Protection. If you eat too many spicy food, what is happening? You get the irritation, you get a lot of saliva to dilute that pungent taste. So protection of your mouth, protection of your tongue from the ushna tikshna property, that bodhaka will help. But that bodhaka, if it is deranged, we can easily understand by our taste perception. I don't feel good taste to the food. Why it is happening? Your bodhaka is not maintained properly. So what, how you can maintain that particular bodhaka? Not excess and not too low. Number one, again, the hydration. If you drink enough amount of water as per your prakruti, as per your agni, you understand, as per your agni and season, grishma rutu, you will have more thirst. In the winter, cooling, rainy season, you will have less thirst, less amount of water is needed. So that particular balance of hydration should be maintained by your body. When the person is dehydrated, his whole mouth becomes dry. No bodhaka kapha is there. loss of appetite is there. When bodhakapha will hamper? In fever, jwara. When excessive pitta is there, there is a water dryness. And because of the water dryness, in the cases of jwara or the fever, patient don't want to eat or patient don't feel a proper taste of the food. Mala annala chavach lagat nahi hai. This is bodhakapha problem. Then there are another methods that you can stimulate this bodhakapha by tongue scraper, jivha nirlekhana. In daily regimen, in dinacharya adhyaya, there is a proper cleaning of brushing of teeth and brushing of tongue is explained. Why it is explained? For bodhakapha. You have to write it down, applicable part. Because that kavala and gandusha, trifala, kavala, your naturally bodhakapha salivary glands will be stimulated and that will be helpful for you. Okay, so all this, now you will say, sir, this is kshaya, but what is vruddhi? Excessive salivation, you know, that is an indication of indigestion. Excessive lalastrava, excessive lalastrava, it's called as a tylism. PTYLI, tylism is an indicator that your inner prathamik sthula pachan is not going well. Your stools are not normal, your appetite is not normal, then you have to give dipana pachana chikitsa, like trikatu tablet. Okay, if there is excessive salivation of the bodhakapha. So this is a bodhakapha shleshaka, very important in the joint region, because again your mobility is a very important part, motor activity is an important part of our life. Otherwise, we are handicapped. If we get a hemiplegia, paralysis, patient is bedridden, what is the use of it? Heart and lung is going on, but that is a visceral, what you can say, the perfectness. But externally, where you want to maintain your dynamic life activity, your mobility with the hands, mobility with the legs, mobility your back should be maintained. So that external mobility is depend on the vata dosha. Try to understand. Vata dosha is responsible for skeletal or musculoskeletal activity. Please write it down. Musculoskeletal activity, muscle activities, bone activities, bony joint activities depend on vata dosha. And if that is also needed when you start walking at the age of 1 year up to your end of your life, you, if you want to get continuous walking, then that vata activity should be counterbalanced. Vata activity should be counterbalanced by kapha. So shleshak kapha is in the joint. Sandhi sansleshat, lubrication, oiling, lubrication, oiling with the synovial fluid. With the synovial fluid, sandhishu sthitaha. Sandhistu shleshma sarva sandhi sansleshat, sarva sandhi anugraham karoti. So some people, including myself, believe that shleshak kapha is primarily concerned with the bony joints. But I believe wherever there are any joints, like bone to ligaments, okay, neuromuscular junction, muscle to muscle, tendon to tendon, axon and dendrites, any two connections, according to me, are sandhi. And any connection is there, there are always kapha molecules around that. Kapha molecules are there. There is must be some lubrication. We are not very specifically mentioned that name. But all other joining places are taken care by shleshak kapha. But majority, on a gross level, you can understand that synovial fluid can be compared with shleshak kapha. Okay? But how to maintain again? If that shleshak kapha lubrication of the bony joints is lost, what will happen? There will be joint pain. Arthritis will start, especially osteoarthritis. Muscle cramps, myalgia, any arthritis. So there is a friction in the two bones and the ligaments. Friction is there on the two surfaces of the bone, and that gives the crepitus. Write down crepitus. In vata dosha, it is mentioned vata dosha prakriti. When the person starts moving, his joints are getting sound. So getting the sound while movement. getting the sound while movement is shlesha kapha kshaya. There is a loss of oiling. So simple thing to maintain shlesha kapha is regularly, weekly, abhyanga. Whole body massage is the best thing for shlesha kapha. Whole body massage with nutrient oil like Narayana tail, Kshirabala tail, and at the joint especially. The knee joint is most important, vertebral column is the most important, because lower backache and the osteoarthritis of the knee joint is because of the body bearing weight. Whole body is put the weight on that, and so that is more degeneration is there. To prevent that degeneration, osteoarthritis problem, every day externally after 40 years of age, ask the person to apply the tila taila, sesame oil, warm, or Narayana taila, gentle oil massage, circular massage, and give the svedana, hot water bag, or electrical para fomentation. So snehana and svedana will help to maintain the physiology of shlesha kapha and to take care of vata dosha problem. And internally also, the person should drink one cup of warm water or one cup of warm milk with one spoon of ghee, G-H-E-E, cow's fresh ghee every day. That can maintain the shlesha kapha. Next. So these are the pictures that you can see over here. Snapshots or print screen. Osteoarthritis, normal joint is shown. Tarpak kapha. So this tarpak kapha is again the very important cuff molecule. Why? Shira samstho akshatarpana tarpaka. It is in the brain. Like heart and lungs, your brain is the most important organ. Because many patients, they are in the coma, they have lost their functions of brain and heart and lungs is going on. So what is the use of that life in the coma? So we must be take care of our brain. So whatever interstitial fluid is there, cerebrospinal fluid is there. What is the nourishing material is in the brain? That is tarpaka kapha in Ayurveda. What that is the doing? Shira samstho aksha tarpana tarpaka. Aksha. Write down that word. Aksha is equal to indriya. Aksha is equal to indriya. Is equal to sensory and motor organs. Sensory and motor organ. Brain center, optic center, 17, 18, 19, occipital lobe, this is temporal lobe, this is occipital lobe, 21, 22, 41, 42, what is that? Auditory centers, 7, 8, 9, 10, intelligence, brain centers, all these centers of sensory, motor. What are the nanendriyas? Shrotra, vak, chakshu, rasana, ghan. What are the karmendriyas? Vak, Pani, Pad, Payu, Pasth. What is Ubhayendriya? Man. So all these centers are here and your brain is also working from birth to death. Again, it is a vata activity and we want to protect our brain, and that is why there is a tarpakta. Now, shirastha sneha santarpana adhikrutatva indriyanam, sensory and motor organs, atma viryena, own potency is there. These molecules have own strength. Anugraham karoti, give the strength to that brain. Now here, aksha and akshi. Aksha is an indriya and akshi is eye. Don't get confused. This is aksha. All indriyas are getting nourishment and stability. Nourishment and stability with the tarpakta. Snehanam snehadanena. All the type of lubricating secretions are there. Samasta indriya tarpanaha bhav prakash. Now, if you want to maintain physiology of tarpakta, two or three things are very important. First is to do the Shirodhara practice. Shirodhara, pouring of the oil. Samanya Vishesh Siddhanta, tarpak kapha quality will be maintained by Shirodhara. Tarpak kapha activity will be maintained by Murdha Taila. Write down Murdha Taila, four types. Shirodhanga, Shirobasti, head, Shirodhara, and Shiropichu, you know, swab of oil. Then you have to put the Nasya with Brahmi Ghrita. That is very essential. Then you have to do the meditation. So the brain activity will be parasympathetic activity. It will be lessened. And then always you get the good amount of good quality of the tarpak kapha. and your brain activities are intelligence, dhi, druti, smriti, buddhi, medha, all is depend on tarpakka. Although there is, you know, we have seen sadhaka pitta, but sadhaka pitta can do its activity if tarpakka is there. Otherwise, only burning will be there. Burning syndrome is there. Because of the lot of stress, the people get the burning syndrome. Very important, write down, foreigners. It is called as a stress syndrome. All is burning, your mental faculty is burned. You can't think properly. Dhi, dhruti, smruti, vibhrashtaha, yat kurute ashubham, prajnaparadhantam vidyat, sarva dosha prakopana. Dhi, dhruti, smruti, vibhrashtaha, yat kurute ashubham. We suffer from prajnaparadha. Why? Because there is a damage to the tarpakka. So do this oil treatment, meditation treatment. Internally also you have to take like for walnuts, then almonds are there, milk is there, ghee is there. All are helping for the tarpakka. Okay. Okay. Let us come to this slide. Kledakka is in the amashaya. It is doing the anna sanghata kledana. Anna sanghata kledana, that is moistening effect. Bodhakaf rasana sthahi. Rasana is a tongue, that is mouth. Rasabodhanath, test perception. Avalambak is puratrika, chest, heart, lungs and mediastinum. Trika sandharana, supporting the physiological functions of heart and lungs. Shleshakaf in the sandhi, that is bony joints. Sandhi sansleshana, that is lubrication of the bony joints. Tarpakaf is in the shira. Akshatarpana, not akshi, aksha, indriya, nutrition of the sensory and motor centers. What can be the problems? Kledakaf is problematic, pathological. GIT problems like hyperacidity, indigestion. If it is low, hyperacidity. If it is excess, kledakaf, indigestion. So for hyperacidity, that means to avoid that drying effect, poor hydration, jaliya dravya, food substances. Bodhakaf, taste perception, proper hydration, jaliya dravya, and also cleaning of the mouth and tongue. Avalambak, heart and lung problems, stop smoking. Very important, and rudabasti, because you know that smoking will damage the avalambak kapha molecules, and smoking is ushna and tikshna. Shleshaka kapha, osteoarthritis, regular oil massage, janubasti, internally milk and ghee. Tarpak kapha is concerned with IQ, intelligence quotient, emotional quotient problems, hyperactive children. So we can use the Brahmi ghrita, shiro abhyanga and shiro dhara. In the last lecture also, I had put this particular slide, which is not, what you can say, the confirmed or consensus slide. This is something research topics. My Guruji, my teacher, below teacher, Vaidya Jagodoshi sir, and his guru, Mama Gokhale, Vaidya Mama Gokhale, renowned personality in the Ayurved field, principal of the Tilak Ayurved Mahavidyalaya Pune and the dean of the Jamnagar University, they postulated, they made this hypothesis that these subtypes of pitta, kapha, vata can be compared with the Mahabhuta predominance. But that correlation can be a research topic. So I just go on passing comments. Kletakaf by them is compared as a apyakaf. Bodhak is a taijasakaf. Okay. Avalambak is a parthiva kaf. Shleshaka nabhasakaf. And tarpaka Vayaviya kapha. This particular theory is still under the process of research. So I am not claiming that this is my final verdict or the student should take it granted. No. This is a topic for rethinking and research for that matter. Okay. So my dear friends, this is nearly the end of my topic. And I am very much thankful to the MUHS, Dr. Kalidas Chavan sir and Mr. Ratnakar Kale sir and the Kedar sir. So for their nice help for arranging my lectures, and I thanks for all these their activities as e-learning in all faculties like MBBS, BMS, BHMS, and I request if the time finishes, he will close from his side, but I will revise all the types in a very fast manner. So just have a look on this. Kledak, Bodhak, Avalambak, Shleshak and Tarpak. These are the five types of kapha. Okay, these are the power stations. I am saying that kapha is the energy plant for the maintenance, nutrition and protection of the human body. Protection, nutrition and maintenance of the human body. Kleidak kapha is taking care of the proper digestion of the food, and that's why if the basic thing in the abdomen is good, tissue metabolism will be good and all the kapha molecules will be good. Bodhak kapha is also the part of our proper digestion process. So Bodhak kapha gives you the signal whether my digestion is good or bad. That can be compared with saliva. Kleidak kapha can be compared with the mucoid secretions in the stomach and all the parts of the GI tract. Then Avalambak kapha can have the comparison with pericardial and pleural fluid, but the interstitial cells, interstitial fluid in between heart and lung tissue, and that is required for Avalambanam iti Swakarmani Samarthyam Utpadayati. Swakarmani Samarthyam, that means they maintain the function of heart and lungs. Shleshak kapha is in the bony joints, is concerned with, compared with the synovial fluid, and that is maintaining the lubrication of all the time moving joints. That is osteoarthritis can be a problem. So you protect, you must do the regular oil massage. Then Tarpak kapha is in the brain, and that is taking care of all the sensory motor organs and the pathways, neurons. So it can be compared with the synovial fluid. And Brahmi Ghruta is there, Shirodhara is there, then Murdha Taila is there. So all the things we can do with this kapha molecules. Lastly, my dear friends, once again, thanks to all. And kapha dosha, shlisha alingane, kena jalena phalena iti kapha. And what are the properties? Snigdha shito gururmandha, shlakshna, sandra, mrutsna, sthira kapha. Okay, so all these properties are applicable to these, all the types. What are those properties? Snigdha shito gurur mandha shlakshna sandra mrudu sthira kapha. And what are the important sthana? Urakkante shiraha kloma parvani amashevrasaha medo ghanam cha jivvacha kafasya sutra muraha. So this is again a fast revision what we can say about the kapha dosha as such, and there is a lot of things to speak about how we can maintain the kapha dosha and how we can maintain the vata pitta and kapha in our body. There is a prakriti concept which I may request to Maharashtra Institute of Health Science to start this particular lecture series regarding the prakriti concept, because that has also relation with vata pitta and kapha. So my dear friends, vata pitta kapha, these doshas are having the definition as a janma maranam, prakrutyarambhakatve sati dushtikartutvam doshatvam. So whenever they are healthy, they maintain our prakruti, they are existing as a genetic type from the birth, and they are there till the death of the person. Okay, but they have a dushtikartutva. When vikruta avikruta deham nanti te vartayanti cha, so when they are avikrut, they are vartayanti, they are maintaining our physiology. But nanti, that means whenever they are avikrut, pathological, they can damage to your body. So doshas are very strong, this particular thing. So all these kapha molecules are also related, ashraya ashraya sambandha, it is related with the rasa dhatu, mams dhatu, medha dhatu, majja dhatu. All these dhatus are connected with the kapha dosha. So naturally, the subtypes of these doshas will act on that particular body tissues. My dear friends, I wish you all the best. Please stay at home and stay safe. And thank you very much for your patience hearing. Thank you very much.